So I just finished playing a game. It was actually off stream. Just somebody else was streaming a game of Go and figured that it could be interesting. Let's see, am I even in full screen mode? Yes, I am. Yeah, it could be interesting to just play a game. And having played it, I'm actually curious about reviewing it now. I don't know how far I'm gonna go with this particular session because there's other games I would like to play as well. Not even necessarily Go games. So this game, I played white. My opponent opened 4-4, as did I. In hindsight, maybe I should have opened 4-4 down on the left side of the board because that's supposed to be the polite thing to do. Anyway, so we end up with I'm approaching a corner. I'm not going to focus on opening Joseki because, there's plenty of things to learn, and over time, just each player gets a general sense of how Joseki flow. This two-space jump in the opening, it's not warranted. I really should be playing on the outside here. I did want to build up some strength here on my opponent's side of the board, but in hindsight, that looks pretty silly. It's easily reduced. And so, yeah, I start playing bigger moves, like protecting my corners. He approaches, and I just had no idea how to counter this. Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry. When he approached earlier, I didn't know how to counter that. That's, again, I don't know Joseki. I shouldn't need to necessarily know them for this sort of thing. I'd probably just, like, run and just keep running up the board or something. Run toward my friendly stone, something like that, maybe. Anyway, I'm playing this. Let's ignore the opening sequence by which we got here, because it's just weird. Got some interesting tactics out of it, though, which is kind of fun. So, yeah, here I connect underneath. I recognize that these stones on. Oh, I need to select a marker if I'm gonna right-click and mark things, or click and mark things. But anyway, these two stones on B10 and C10 are dead. So, yeah, I'm not sure what else White should do other than trying to connect there. I think, of course, now that he's fully connected, he's played two moves, given me Sente. While I've still connected kind of loosely, I do need to react, so I have to invest that move to strengthen these two before they get killed. Wait, was it here? Where was it when I concluded that these two were dead? B9. Is B9 where I thought these two were dead? Yeah, because in any conceivable capture race. In fact, can I go into Zen mode while I'm analyzing? Yes, I can, but that looks horrible. Let's go back. How do I escape? Oh, there's how I escape Zen mode. So, yeah. He's playing kind of slowly, attacking my stones. I protect. He could just keep attacking me from the inside of the board. So he could, like, approach from on top with F10. I think he's got more than enough stones to support it, and I'll have to run one way or the other. Another idea might be just to. Well, in fact, that's what he did play. But, yeah, surrounding a group in the middle of the board requires surrounding it on all four sides. So if he starts to press, well, they say in Go, your stones have three directions to run, basically. You can never count on having all four directions to run, but here he's building up some strength on all three sides of my two stones, we'll say. And I recognize I could still run if I need to, I think. This is actually an interesting calculation exercise. Supposing that you and your opponent have played recklessly and gotten into this sort of situation. If a capture race arises, how's this going? We're both like forming some kind of pinwheel thing here. Yeah, I don't know how to evaluate that. Basically, when both players are putting stones in the same section of the board, either they're going to reach some sort of peaceful compromise as to where, who gets what territory, or a capture race is going to ensue and blood will spill everywhere. The move he played was C13, which prevents me from connecting my stone to my other stones. But then, he's got basically, we'll call this one group up here, we'll call this one group here, we'll call this one group here. He's creating a fourth group by going up here. And my stone at C14 was just like volunteering to help out, but now he's kind of forcing me to make it useful. So it does extend influence now. And boy, it was tempting, this move. This move was tempting me because I guess he has to play that, actually. It's Atari. Not all temptations are terrible. Somehow I'd evaluated that this wasn't working. But no, this is pretty clearly just crushing if I play it. That just seemed really weird because I've never seen this kind of interlaced formation. Nobody would play C13 in this sort of position, and so it really spooked me. And he got away with it. So that was interesting. Apparently, I could just play this. He'd have to connect, and I just win a stone. No, I don't have to take it right away. But here it does actually like connect all my stones back together. That's not to say that what I did was bad either. Actually, this just wins a stone and a territory, right? And safeguards all my stones, but it gives him Sente. Instead, what I ended up playing in the game took Sente, which is worth more than one stone here. So rather than winning one, I won like two stone and two territory. That was surprisingly good. It's like I'm learning something here. I guess he does extend his group, which makes some sense. It's just really slow. He keeps committing more stones to the same block of the board. I'm not sure if I should have played this. I hesitated a lot. I do feel that my stones are weak, but I don't think that that feeling is justified. What I'd want to do is just like play out here and just slowly net and enclose this thing. But I think there's some practical problems here. I don't know, maybe there's not. Maybe this is fine. Yeah, what am I so afraid of here? I'm afraid that he's going to push with D15 or C15. No, I can't do that. I'm an Atari. Although losing that Atari might not be the worst thing ever. Something like this is, I guess, what I was concerned about. So this gives him influence in the corner. This is what happens if I'm greedy and I try to surround this, and I'm not even going to succeed in surrounding it, but if I even attempt to, That's just wholly misguided. Let's not intend to go that far forward or back. Let's use the arrow keys to navigate the move list. So, yeah, I pushed, or, yeah, I guess that is a push. But it also just connects my stones. Now, I'm sure I've got some weaknesses on the other side of this. Maybe I should have done C15 instead. Yeah, we got some Go going on. I'm actually looking at a game I just played and trying to figure out some of the more subtle nuances of what's going on here. So if he Ataris, like my stone's in peril, I've got to protect it. And if any kind of race happens here, he might get something. I think he's throwing stones after bad stones here if he keeps playing in this area. I think I'm too solidly connected for that to work directly. Something like this might have better chances of inflicting damage. I think I'll have to like react, I don't know, somewhere. Yeah. This is my 12th stream of me playing Go. And apparently I'm getting okay at it. I have done a lot of Sumo Go just on the side, just for fun, but well, okay, I'm not going to be able to solve this particular thing. But I think I'm doing okay overall here. Yeah, I did play that other streamer who was doing stuff because it looked like he was having some fun. And it looked like we'd have a pretty even game. And that didn't actually happen that way. Although we did have some interesting game anyhow. Yeah, so he surrounded my stone. But I still think this is good. Again, I'm accidentally, although it would be a good thing, giving up a stone and a territory just so I can get Sente, apparently. So I use my move to invade the corner. This is called a shoulder hit. I mean, I certainly get the gist that like this is very close to that stone, and I guess that's where it gets the name of that kind of hit from. I was expecting him to do something to like react to any of these three that were down here. Like something like here maybe. If not there, maybe here. I'm not sure. I expected some kind of reaction. But instead, he went after this group of two. Actually, he went after this particular stone, because this group of two are living, because these two are dead. He'd have to somehow sneak in A8. He'd have to get an extra move in there somehow for free in order to kill these two. Yeah, so he's just going after this stone, and I guess protecting his lower left corner, which is positive. There's benefit to that. So yeah, I take the big corner and say, you know what? Okay, yeah, you're right. That corner's yours. Never mind. There's probably a local way to respond to this, though, right? I mean, other than this. This is one heck of a local response, but why did I play down here at B7 if I didn't have a local response prepared for that? I mean, I did consider this. I just didn't like it very much. In hindsight, it makes my B7 all look pretty silly. It bugged me that he was putting all these stones on this section of the board and I didn't have anything there. It really did. I think In hindsight, like if I wanted to respond locally somehow, I don't know, maybe something like this, where I take the inside of the board and he connects, and I don't know, something like this maybe might be okay. Maybe not. That's optimistic. That is so optimistic. First of all, why do I think he's going to, I mean, he doesn't have to respond there. I'm not actually threatening to cut him, am I? Maybe I am. No, he doesn't have to respond there. He can even throw in something down here for free. But yeah, this is fine. And then he gets to react over here, and you know, I've taken a little small section of the center. He's taken the corner. That's probably a more normal way to play that sort of thing. You know, this is like early access Go 2.0. They're still working on Go 2.0. And then they're working on one that's like Bug House that's going. No, I'm messing with you, but so yeah, I don't think he needed to play this. Although it does separate my stones. I still wonder if there is some sort of local response I can make to that other than just taking the two makes no difference. Yeah, I don't know. This actually is a local response, and it seems fine. And then if he plays as he did, I'm losing my stone, but it's only just a stone. And yeah, I think I actually did okay. So the game proceeds. He kills my other stone because I'm paying no attention. I wonder, is this B6? No, B6 is forced. It's not an overplay, because forced moves are not never overplays. If I try to surround this, I die. That's pretty obvious to everybody except me. I mean, I could do some silliness like this. I'm getting surrounded, but, you know, having some fun doing it. Yeah, this seems unwise. Where did this start to go wrong? Oh, right. So I was saying let's not look at these complicated sequences. But no. This here, this C9 might have been the complicated business that just that caused me to lose this C6 stone. So that's perhaps the inception of where this got really confusing. So I wonder, could I have done something smarter? Well, now I'm getting into Joseki. I don't need to fixate on that because I won't memorize or fully understand most of that for a while. But yeah, we got some confusing stuff going on. Earlier, I was suggesting, what if he just like tries to trap me? Oh, but then I run, but I still have this one point to break out of this ladder thing. So this ladder could extend to the end of the board. I have no stone to support it. If I choose to go the other way, Is this not a ladder going the other direction? I'm honestly counting this out because, okay, because I'm not very good with ladders. So yeah, maybe this one move would have been okay. If I'm not missing something pretty fundamental at the start of this. How does this work? Okay, that breaks the ladder. So one actually doesn't work there. No matter which way you play this, the ladder just fails. If he tries to continue with this, then what? We just break this at any point, right? Yeah. So, plus I have that extra liberty, so I could just break this whenever I feel like breaking it, right? It's not like if he plays there I lose everything, because I still have this one spare liberty. And then I just kill something. Okay, so those are 2 points about ladders that we're learning the hard way. So, I guess he plays that to surround me. Such that if a ladder erupts from this, he's like half a move closer to settling it. I'd still need to like approach this stone and get trapped somehow. But if he got in this move for free, then yeah, that stone would trap me. But I think he's more interested in running at this point than trying to net me. He's not like... I could even try to do this here and be all silly. I considered this, it seemed really weird because it's his turn, so he gets to do this with tempo or sente or whatever. And now I have this defective shape that I have to spend some turns connecting. Either now or later. So that didn't seem very wise. So I guess that's why I didn't play it. But also, I considered this. C7. It's not clear to me what's going on. So I guess here I don't manage to connect my stones. That's kind of a huge negative, especially because these three aren't alive either. They create some potential for me to do tricky stuff, but yeah, I don't know about this. This wouldn't be my first choice. So just as a good general move, I try to connect. Connect my one stone to my two. Admittedly, this is gonna take some cooperation, I guess. Because, like, if he... A10 is silly, but... yeah, he could build up some extra liberties for himself. I might choose to connect, although connecting is silly. This is better. This gets me some liberty. So we both get some liberties. And then he threatens to connect underneath. And... oh, I win the race. Never mind. Am I just winning this race after B9? I guess that's the ultimate question I'm trying to ask and answer here. I don't see a way that he can live after B9. Which seems really weird. I mean, yes, he's played three groups of stones, and I've played three groups of stones, so how strange is it that... Well, I guess he's played the one group that is surrounded on all three sides, surrounded toward the center, and on its left and on its right. This small group here, and it is a small group. It has very few liberties. And it's just in the wrong place at the wrong time. All the other groups have space to extend into. Like, this white group can extend toward the corner. This white group can attempt to extend toward this corner, and all the black stones can extend toward the center, but these two have nowhere to go. Even these white stones could try to run toward the center. These two have nowhere to run, so I correctly clamp down on that. And then I take Sente. I give myself, although with the Sente, I do have to make sure I don't get trapped. At least I thought I did. It's concerned about B12. If I do absolutely nothing, like say I play this, I think he plays B12 himself. I don't think this works out for me. So these two are dead. And if I try to net him, he can just run. So yeah, this is not so great. So I think, yeah, I do have to react to this stone. I considered A12, and then I'm like, well, why am I even considering that? This directly protects my two, and acknowledges the fact that there is a capture race. Note that if he goes B12 directly, I just have this. Maybe this is what might have puzzled me about the game, is that sure, I get that in, but he connects, right? He's getting out. So maybe that's what stumped me about this whole situation. It's like, how could I have completely surrounded those two with no deficiencies? I guess the deficiency is that, like, if a capture race erupts, I'm not winning it. Like, there, I don't win the capture race. If I go here, I don't win the capture race. So, okay. Yeah, apparently this, which my only intent was just to connect my stones, it had a most devious effect here. And had he just played the more direct move of just giving up one stone, he could have been alive, because now he's threatening these two, so I have to protect. And yeah, he gets two stones for the price of one. So what that means is that supposing he plays a B12, what am I supposed to do? Could it be that B13 was just a dumb move, just a bluff that shouldn't have worked? B13 seems unwise now. I'm so proud of it, but yeah, maybe I just had to play B11. And note that if he runs, he's not getting anywhere. So yeah, I guess C13, trying to snatch these two, runs into B11. Which is all to say that even though I was proud of this move, that move's terrible on account of B12. On the other hand, C13 is also terrible on account of B11, preventing B12. Or at least making sure it doesn't kill me. So, wait. Is my stone surrounded? If I do this, it looks like. Oh, wait, why did I take that? I'm forced to take. He connects, and I can't kill that small group. So. Yeah, C13 isn't even terrible. Just gives up two stones, which were kind of dead anyway. And has the benefit of invading my side of the board a bit. It certainly breaks up my stones down here, so I have to spend some time fixing something. I need a second eye. It really doesn't look like I'm getting a second eye. This is complicated. Yeah, I don't know. There's no general advice to be had here other than capture races are tricky. So, okay, but anyway, the way the game proceeded, he played a really solid move. I played a kind of solid move. And he's sneaking up on my stones there. I take the corner. I take more of the corner. He reacts. I react. Finally, one of us does something toward the top of the board, which we should have been doing all along. I react on the top of the board again. I try to assert as much territory as I can, although. Well, let's see. I think he does react and I re. No. I'm not impressed by that. Seems to me black could. Well, I don't know. Maybe H17 is right. There's pros and cons to everything here. I reacted solidly with H18. It's possible I might have been able to cut in here. I was worried about this. I'm an Atari, so I gotta run. This didn't seem right. Okay. So he does connect. He gets a stone. And I don't know. Do something like this, maybe. So I've protected both my corners. It's okay. Yeah, so basically going into the middle of this would be ridiculous. So I just protect up here or connect up here. This could have been fun. Yeah, I'm not sure where this would have gone. Anyway, I connect. He plays another solid connecting move. I just choose not to react to this G17. I'm not sure why. I think there was just more of a mental block than anything else. There's no need to keep throwing stones where I have lots of stones already. This probably would make a lot more sense. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, he pushes there. I connect. He. See, I think the movie should have played here would have been just like F18, continuing pushing. And then I have to like set up a wall here to just make sure I don't lose my entire corner. And then from this strength he's built up, then he could start building things this way too. And try to go toward my other corner. I think. I could be wrong. I often am. So, yeah, this is. Perhaps a misclick. I can't imagine why somebody would play T10 instead of like, or T11 instead of, I don't know, S11 or S12 or anything else in that vicinity that's not on the edge of the board. That's probably a misclick. He didn't opt to try to take it back, so we just kept going. So now I get greedy. But also, no, I mean, he's building up a lot of stones right next to each other. So I do need some way to connect F15 to D15. because I'm concerned he might play at e15 and try to connect right through me here. Like, say I do, I don't know, something like this. If he plays this, I guess he's still too slow. Well, I don't know. It's messy. Yeah, I think actually I'm losing my stones there because it's too slow. So if he plays here, I have to try this. Try to keep him separated. And. Oh, wait. He's forced to react. This is Atari. Least I think he is. I'm not sure. And I don't think I'm winning any capture races that happen here. I could just keep going for more territory, which would be a good thing in general. It's probably actually worth it to do it that way, but assuming I didn't have that option to like nail down lots and lots of territory, yeah, I would have to react as I did in the game with this. Or e15 if I'm feeling that I'm in serious danger. I didn't feel that here. I think if he plays this, I do have to react like that. He's got this then. See, maybe e15 would have been more prudent. Anywho, yeah, we're both pretty bad at reading, it seems. Which leads to some interesting situations that should have, I don't know, been quelled earlier. Should have been ameliorated. Should have been, I don't know, mitigated. Anyway, should not have gotten to this extreme stage where everything's threatening everything and everything's all dying at once. Yeah, we should never have gotten here. But we got here, so thanks to us arriving at this complicated position, I did have this opportunity to play F11. And now I'm winning not just the two stones down here, but also I'm winning this group of six right there. And if he tries to extend it, or if he tries to increase, to run out, this only increases my reward for killing it. And you think, well, can't he just run first and then connect these two to the rest? And the answer is no. I've got to throw it. It just kills those right off the bat. At this point, I had sufficiently confused him and myself, and we said, you know what? It's been a fun game. Congratulations, I win. But yeah, that was really confusing. That's double-digit Q. It's double-digit, yeah, that is the term. DDK or double-digit Q games, where some really funky stuff happens. So I don't know, do people prefer this view or do they prefer. People do like when I have the ability to review the games, but I actually prefer playing them using the Ancient Go client. So if I can get that up and running, we'll do that. Not just because the music's amazing, which it is. Let's see if we can get that client up and running. Any second now? Oh, it says it's running. Which, given the fact that I'm not seeing it, is kind of unfortunate. But I'm sure it'll be there any. There we are. Any second now. Oh yeah, you can hear that graphics card burning. Let's try that. Nope. All right. Anti-cheat compatibility hook. No such luck. Okay, any full screen application. Multi-adapter compatibility? No, that's not it. It's gotta be here somewhere. Fine. Capture window by name. Or by window class. Ichinko. Alright. Oh, there we go. That was less painful than it could have been. Oh, hey, look. I get to provide my password, because the game forgot it. One second. Also, I better hit the mic. Alright, so if I remember right, a common time control is 300 seconds, 5 yoyomi at 30 seconds apiece. Let's do it ranked, because people like to play ranked games. Oh, 19 by 19. Yeah. Let's try that. Move the mic back here. Public game. Let's see. Also, this is kind of an experiment to see whether or not the stream will work. Oh, hey look, I go first. Whether or not to see the stream will work at the new recommended streamer guideline of 3 megabits per second. The stream is live, but if I don't have quality options, it's going to be an uphill battle for people to be watching this. Okay, let's take the right side of the board. And approach. Super aggressive approach move. Okay, so I take this side of the board. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do about that. That seems like a local situation for sure. I don't know if that's urgent enough that I'm forced to react to it. Really feels like it is, I just don't know where to go. Let's try reacting here, saying I'm willing to pull back a little bit if you will. Okay, now that's just ridiculous. Okay, let's try to invade the other corner. Maybe build up something between the two corners. Prevents me from extending. I'm not sure what to do about that. We'll take the star point, because that looks cool. It also threatens to connect on top. Connecting on top is going to be... he really wants that corner. I want it too. Okay, so... not entirely sure what's going on here. I'm going to two-space jump to just build some kind of strength here somewhere. Maybe I should two-space jump right into the middle of this nonsense, too. Seems pretty extreme. I don't know. That playing style confuses me very much. I don't know where to go. There's a lot of territory unclaimed, because apparently nobody's interested in attempting to claim it. I'll take the corner. It just seems silly. But, yeah, if I just protect my corners, I guess that's worth something. I don't know anything about this opponent, this Aquarelle. Okay. That's not very nice. It's a strange approach move. I guess we'll forbid a two. We'll forbid them from building a base here. So we'll take the two space jump on this side, and we've already taken the two space jump on the other side. So the only side they can approach from would be the center. Yeah, I don't know about that. I can guard down here. There's some weakness in this. Okay. So I'm gonna let him claim a little bit of territory up at the top. In exchange, I get this cool looking shape. This is so weird. But I think I'm okay. Okay. I don't think he's gonna cut me. Rather, if he does cut me, I think I'm surviving it. So, yeah, I'm not sure what happens next. Am anticipating that I do not have quality options from Twitch because, I probably have a livelier audience. We'll see. We'll check out the dashboard, see just if this is a function of me being strange or Twitch being strange or both. So this is why I considered that earlier maybe I should have connected these. I do lose apparently my stone in the corner. So I think that's fine. It's just a stone. I'm surviving this. Well, I do have quality options. So people are able to view this. Even people with not the strongest internet connections. That's pretty spiffy. So, yeah, he's gotten two eyes already. Oh, I'm in time trouble. Where do I want to take? Here, let's build up some strength on both sides of this shape. Try to build a base everywhere. He did get that corner. But I'm doing okay. Hey, welcome. We're just playing some Go. You can probably actually hear that CPU fan in the background. That's me transcoding this. I wonder, I'll have to try changing the settings sometime and see like if it transcodes better. Oh, I'm supposing that what do I want to say here? Supposing I do 30 FPS instead of 60. I'm trying 60, seeing if it works. But maybe I should drop back to 30 FPS, especially for turn-based gaming. On the other hand, the 60 looks beautiful when you look at the video on demand, so. Wait, why am I not invading this? Let's take it. All right, we're in Byo-Yomi the first of five. But yeah, I think I have more than enough territory to win this on account of owning the bottom, the right, and a large part of the top edge of the board. So I think I'm doing excellently. Do I want to cut or peep? Cutting looks good. I want to see what happens if I cut. If I go there, I'm basically self-atarying. I can't do that. I can go here, though. No, he can atari me basically wherever I go. If I go there, he goes here, I go. Huh? I actually win this race. Never mind. So, yeah, if I can pick off this stone, I can connect all my stones together through it. And what should happen is that he should give up the stone and get some sort of concession elsewhere. Oh, I'm miscalculated. I miscalculated. That's my mistake. So I'm giving up two stones instead of one. At least I'm not giving up three. I see my mistake before it completely gets out of hand. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say transcoding. I'm encoding at 60 FPS. I think if I do this, I have enough territory to live. So, wait, oh, he connects there. That makes sense, I think. Okay, I connect all my stones together. Oh, I just made a clump of five. Think this giving up the stone makes more sense than trying to hold on to it. Oh, but he's willing to let me keep it. I cut you. This is fun. And unexpected, I'm sure. Oh, okay, I'll take that. I will certainly take that. So now I've made, a living shape that's got two eyes there. All right, let's not get trapped. How am I gonna live? I guess this protects everything out here. Yeah, I don't want that to extend to infinity, so we're gonna try to rein that in a little bit. That's what I should have done earlier, but that's okay, I still have time to react. Right, I'm an Atari. I'm twice an Atari. I don't want my upper group here to die, so we're gonna try to keep that together. Oh, I'm an Atari again. My mistake. Well, this is weird. So I kill that. Oh, I don't. I'm sorry, if I go here, he kills me. So, yeah, let's keep this together. Push just to keep this alive. This would be walking into a ladder down here, except I have all the stones so the ladder doesn't kill me. Like, I have these stones that if we did ladder, I'd be okay. And then I'd be able to come back and kill the ladder that tried to kill my stones. So I think I'm still doing excellently on territory. All right, another Atari, so I react to that. Think I'm fine. This is suicide. Let's not do that. It's fancy. This, somewhere around here is where I should be putting a stone, though. Somewhere it's a fair distance away, but it still it exerts some influence to try to stop him from running. Just build up this wall. Okay. Didn't expect that. Plowing into it doesn't make any sense. I know he's gonna go right there. Well, I thought. I was pretty sure. All right, let's just put some stones together. Try to connect. I guess if I don't get to connect, that's not the end of the world, but it's just very strange. Usually in Go, you try to control some territory. He does control the upper left and lower left corners. So I've got a million cutting points, but he controls no territory, so. Oh, but I keep walking into this. I've played too thin. Yeah, he can just cut me, basically anywhere. All right. So let's connect my stones together. Or die trying, I suppose. So, yeah, he's formed one very large living group. Living is better than dying. So I'm going to try to live this way. And apparently I fail. Where do I cut my losses here? So, yeah, I lost a large section of the cent. Well, no, I could try to play something in the outside here. It bugs me that the Byo-Yomi's 30 seconds. I did have the option to change that before the game, and I failed to do so. Because more time would certainly help me with reading this out. Like, some days you see I played some pretty casual games. Didn't do very well at reading at all. Here I'm actually making a concerted effort to try to read. Still not doing very well, but doing a little bit better. Yeah, no, those stones are dead. You don't need to keep ganging up on them. All right, let's connect that. And then, I don't know. Gotta find some kind of reasonable inroad into this position. Let's connect that. Okay, we've settled that territory. Let's prevent a cut. That's a very endgamey sort of move I'm playing. Alright, so he's moving in on my group, so I'm going to try to get some influence with it. This time, instead of immediately spreading myself thin, I'm going to build up a little bit of strength there by extending, and then try to move in. Okay, so finally, I guess the jig is up there. Why didn't I just play right next to it? Well, I guess now I have the chance to. So these are all pretty solidly connected. That's aggressive. That's very aggressive. Well, I guess that is Hane at the head of two stones, but it just seems like, of all the places you could do that, why there? It does reduce this territory, so give credit where credit's due, but... this is kind of a wasted move. Okay, let's not play immediately next to that because I don't have the strength to do so. But try to enclose this somehow. He really doesn't like being enclosed. Yeah, that Hane, that first line move is an endgame move. And there's so much more to be played here. There's no need to play endgame moves just yet. Okay. I approach. What is this? This is lots and lots of cutting points. But also doesn't control any territory. All right, so we'll enclose this. There we go. Yeah, he's forced to fill there. He's still okay. I almost got very lucky, but that would have been silly. All right, so play on the outside of that. Just make sure I don't get enclosed any more than the guy. I just don't get why you would keep continuing with this pattern. This is really weird. So, I mean, eventually you're gonna have to patch all the holes if you want to, like, connect and not die. So, I don't understand this. Yeah, I'm not sure. I ended up losing a number of stones in the center of the board. I feel pretty, I don't know, content with what I've done here. I think I'm doing okay, but winning, I'm not sure. I think he is helping me out a lot here, but I'm not sure again. I don't like my first line move, but I'm getting nervous because I'm in time trouble. Also, I'm really anxious to see how this concludes. Okay, that makes an eye. Also gets close to starting a capture race. Oh, I get it. Okay. So, yeah, unlike Sumego, this one's not like instantly decided. He actually does live long enough to connect his stones, and then make the territory he's claiming. That's the nuance here. Is that we are in an end game, He's using that pattern of stones to build a large territory. So my question is now, can I live? As opposed to, can I kill? Mean, I think if I play there, I've got a second eye, so I'm living for sure. Think this is good somehow. I could be imagining things. Oh, that was clumsy of me, wasn't it? Well, I'm not killing that group now for sure. Now he's totally alive. Okay, do I have any interesting moves here? Yeah, it does give you self-Atari warnings. Honestly, I'm not too concerned if, well, do we really think that self-Atari warnings are unfair assistance? Is anybody really raising an issue about that? Just to be safe. Wait, well, we played here. I cost myself one territory to play a safe move there that just makes two eyes immediately. I don't seem to have much in the way of interesting moves here. That was a wasted move. That doesn't actually threaten anything. Not anything serious enough that to force my opponent to react to. He chose to react to it, but he didn't have to. In before Sansan invasion. Yeah, that's happening, and who knows where we're going to end up after that invasion does occur. Sansan is 3-3, you know? Least I've confused him. This is weird. He's got an eye there and an eye up here, so. It's kind of unlikely that I'm going to be able to make progress here. So, best I've got a Koth right up there. He doesn't have to react to this either. Oh, just take the 3-3 invasion off the board. That's actually a really good point. I'll protect it. Why not? Oh, he invades anyway. Well, that's a bold move. It's a stone for a stone down here, so it does not hurt me at all to counter this. That's not to suggest that it helps, but it doesn't hurt. The only case where it hurts is if I'm actually bad at countering these, which I kind of am. So there's that. But no, if you're good at Go, there's no harm in countering these invasions. So I don't want him to get two eyes. Which means I do need to play here. To stop the second eye from happening there. This is the online Go server, playing with the ancient Go client. Yeah. Okay, so I just hope I don't screw up. I should calm down and slow down a bit. I'm just really anxious to get this resolved. Because there's a lot of tension here. Oh, it is? Actually, no, it's not possible with this client to view coordinates. Sorry about that. Okay, so it's Atari. How do I counter this? I go second line or third line? I think second line, honeying here, is reasonable. Because he can't connect his groups and still form as many eyes as he needs. That's Atari. Having some good fun with this invasion stuff. But no, I think it works out in my favor. Since all the stones down there are dead, I only expended the 3-3 stone, giving up one territory. Well, that's true. He technically doesn't have a real eye just yet. So he's going to keep attempting to form an eye. I guess I have to Atari here. He could have Atari'd me there, though, couldn't he? Well, I'm still an Atari, so I have to react. I screwed up because I'm losing some. Nope. This is a ladder. No, I'm an Atari. I have to react. He did note a he correctly noted a cutting point though. So he's going to go here next. I'm going to lose two stones. That's a mistake on my part. That sucks. Let's not lose this entire group up here. We'll connect. Again, I can't lose this group up here. I need to form at least two eyes. That's Atari. So it's easier to react to Ataris than to other plays. It's also Atari. So this is greatly reducing my territory if he can connect here. So now what? Connect everything together this way. So I lost a ton of territory, which arguably maybe I overplayed and I didn't have that territory to begin with. So, staying calm and keeping a level head can be a good thing. I mean, yeah, I guess I am collecting a number of stones, so the fact that I've conceded some space isn't the end of the world. He played somewhere. Oh, up here. So he's finally closing in. Okay, that's Atari. That's taking a whole bunch of stones because he didn't react to the Atari. Okay, I'm an Atari. Let's react to that. Right, he gets those. I don't know how to play here. That 1-4 move's probably unnecessary. I don't know how scoring works in terms of this interface, so I'm not sure whether that would have counted for me or not. I guess, yeah, everything I lose in. Okay, white passes, I pass. Let's score this. Black wins by 16 and a half. Yeah. Okay, so I didn't need to play that 1-4 stone. The interface is pretty smart. Now, had we gone back just a touch, before I took this big glob of stones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, had he just played, had he not taken there, but had he just like played right here, I wouldn't have had the 10 stones that I collected by capturing that. Plus, I wouldn't have the 10 territory. So it looks like if he played there, that would have been a 20-point move, or something approximately 20 points. He didn't play that. So the fact that I won by 16 and a half couldn't, the game could have ended differently, you know? Yeah, that was close. Now it could be that this interface is just wrong, that this wasn't a 16 and a half point victory. I'm not sure. But yeah, apparently, oh, I see. Wait. It's 7.5 Comey for playing second. I'm confused. We both passed once. The territory's pretty even. I captured a couple more stones. Yeah, I'm thinking that this interface isn't telling the numbers as they are. Because it says Comey for playing second is 7.5, which it is, but it's putting that in my column. Wait, also two in the left were marked dead when they should have been marked alive. No, the interface did automatically remove dead stones, but you're saying that two on the left that were alive got marked dead somehow. I guess I could boot up the client and see. I'm sorry, not the client, but just the website, onlinego.com, and take a look at how this game resolved there. I know the scoring is resolved server side, so whatever the client says isn't the ultimate say. It's whatever the server says is the result. But how do I view my most recent game? Game has ended. Switch to night theme. Switch coordinates to like that. And then we'll pop open the, here we are. So yeah, you guys can see this. Cool. Black wins by 16 and a half. Oh, these two. These two on E12 and E11 were removed. Yeah, technically those are alive. Because white could play at either point as an Atari, but I take the other point. So I wonder why those are removed. Like, I'm not even saying it's wrong. It looks wrong, but I'm not sure. Now we're talking about E12 and E11 here. Why would those be removed in this situation? Play it out. Alright, so if I go back a couple moves, analyze mode. Both players passed, but you know, I'm thinking it's probably this. Oh, D11. Okay. Sorry, my mistake. C12. Yeah, sometimes there are glitches, but I'm more inclined to trust the website than trust myself at this. Yeah, no, these are just alive though. So yeah, I should have noticed that and marked them. That was my mistake. But even with that mistake, I did manage to win because earlier in the game, my opponent had made a huge, huge blunder. That blunder being this move here, which conceded this entire block of stones and the territory. In theory, these corner invasions should be something easier to resolve. Actually, I have weakness here. There's a cutting point right there. So yeah, if I wanted to be like ultra solid, where I should have played would not be 3-3, but like right next to or on the cutting point, like right there would be a far safer place to secure this. I think that's a takeaway here. The cut always worked. So, say like, instead of him playing here, which I don't think he had to do, he could have just played right here right away. Oh, and tried to get something out of it. Not necessarily... He's threatening to Atari, so I have to like counter here. No, I can't do that. That's what I did in the game, too, and that just dies. Pretty horrible. No, it doesn't, because I still have this. Okay, never mind. But I have to win this capture race very quickly, which I'm capable of doing, so yeah, this is fine. Huh. Yeah. Interesting. Since black should protect either point up front. That's what marks something. Oh. Okay. Wait, are you talking about this cut or that cut? The one on the left or the one on the right? Thank you. Let's see. Yeah, there's nothing for white. Although, the way it played out in the game, I did manage to give white a really big thing, because I didn't dismiss this threat correctly here. But yeah, the ones on the left, that's got to be a scoring glitch. But this business on the right, similar to what happened in the game, that cut is always a threat. And as such, at some point in the game, I do need to... that was forced. Oh, I'm sorry. When he plays here, he's actually Atari-ing me. So that cut always works. So even if we go all the way back up the stack here, like, he's got this. I have to respond like that. I can't immediately threaten to capture it, because now he's got two threats. If I protect there, he can Atari me here. So, yeah. Against this, I always have to do that. But he's getting something out of this. It's not totally clear to me what he's getting, but there's always something here. Oh, hang on. That always just works. Well, how about that? Isn't that fancy? Huh. Well, it's a bit of an adventure. Yeah, a group of two, having two stones there doesn't increase my liberty count. So that's really easily surrounded. Okay, that's pretty funny that we both missed that, but that's why we're beginners. Thankfully, the way the game played out, I still won it, but it was a learning game, for sure. Oh, that said, maybe I'll play a quick game. Let's see if we can get a 9x9 in. Sure. We're only doing ranked because this way we can find an opponent. Opponents tend to prefer ranked games over unranked ones, I think. So, if we can find an opponent, that's great. If not, that's okay too. Alright. I'll take the center. The fact that I go first probably means that I'm the lower rated player. Okay, I'm already pretty seriously confused by what's going on. But such is the nature of 9x9. Don't expect it to make sense. Let's cut. Sure, why not? Prevent him from taking this corner. So, yeah, I don't know where we're going with this, but it's fun. Okay, we'll take this too. And the fight begins. Although he's got Sente, so I should be more afraid than I am. If I keep my stones together, I can run this like river right through the middle of the board. Hopefully get something out of it. Interesting. Okay. Well, we've got a thing going on here. Guess the left side is his. I'm not sure about the rest of the board. Okay. Sure. I guess. Right, let's try playing there. And here. And just. I don't know, can I surround this thing in the corner? Or. I guess that is alive now, isn't it? I've created a monster. So I have no territory. My opponent has all the territory. So now I have to kill it all. this is not wise. Okay. This is seriously unwise. I don't think this is gonna work, guys. Hate to break it to you, but this is not looking good. So far, every time like I've tried to amass this big center strength, it's worked out beautifully. There's a first time for failure on anything. So the only way this works is if I have enough center territory to make up for effing up all four corners. I don't think that's the case. Or unless I can find a way to kill this thing, which would be quite impressive. Let's see, yeah, can I kill this? I'm an Atari. I gotta respond to that. No, I can't, unless I can, like, take both of those points, which I cannot. What's Atari here? Yeah, no, he forms two eyes. There's no stopping it. We'll try to stop it. Entirely in vain. Yeah, that didn't work so well. All right, we'll try to reduce the corner and hope that what territory I have surrounded counts for something. Or hope that he plays. I don't even know how he could mess this up. It's got a large advantage. I'm kind of forced to play on here. Only because I'm lost if I don't play on. Yeah, I can concede this. Well. I think conceding was accurate. I think I counted right. If not, I just feel stupid, but either way. Yeah, he gets a handicap for going second. He controls the entire first column, those three and the upper three. Yeah, the scoring's backwards. That's what's confusing me. My opponent has 15 territory. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait, how much is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, so I have 15. I counted 15 for my opponent. Plus the prisoner that's in the left column. So territory-wise, we're even. Prisoner-wise, he's captured two already and surrounds one of mine, so that's he's up by three, then plus Comey. So he's winning by a much larger margin than indicated here. He's winning by, I think, 8.5. Let me check this out. It's 27 stone, 3 territory, 5.5 Comey, 35.5 to my. That doesn't make sense. Huh. Oh, I see what's wrong with the estimator. Okay, yeah, the client here, this client is correctly estimating that all the territory on the left is white's. One could theoretically debate that, no, there's a black stone on the left column, but sensible would acknowledge that those 12 points on the left are white's. The only way that black can manage to see that left column wraps around in a single line. The only way that this could work out for black, I guess, is if Secchi were to occur. I was gonna say if black occupies all those points at the same time, but no, all black has to manage is a Secchi, which is still like light years beyond where this position is. Basically, what black should be attempting to do is occupy like everything other than the two ends here, and then just keep trying to place stones in the middle of this formation over and over and over, and hope white never cuts that single eye into two eyes. But yeah, if white does something sensible like putting a stone anywhere that makes a second eye on the left, then that's just immediately game. Like there's nothing black can do, even given an infinite number of moves, to overcome that obstacle. Oh, interesting hallucination here. For a while I was thinking I'd just play something in one of these two points and threaten to do something. Turns out, yeah. If I placed in either of those two points, I couldn't place a stone in the other one because that would be a suicide move. This is okay. The fact that I stopped where I did, I mean, it's still later than I should have stopped, but so I played a lot of really solid moves and it just didn't work out at all. I'm gonna play solidly. I can't like combine this solid playing into my opponent's position with weak stones everywhere else. I have to figure out, am I gonna play solidly or am I gonna play interestingly? Because can't really choose both. And here I like approached with nothing supporting it, and it's just a mess. Anyway, that was a fun game. Even if I lost that by 12 points, still good. I didn't lose by 12, I lost by 8.5, but you get the idea. Anyhow, yeah. I still think that game I analyzed at the beginning of the session was one of the more interesting of the three, four, I lost count. There are some lessons to be learned from it, especially just how much room there is to improve with reading. So I hope you had fun. Might come back with another game later today. So, thanks for watching, and see you next time.